Did you know that biological males and females have different processes for producing sex cells? In humans, our somatic, or non-sex cells, are diploid, which is designated as 2N. This means that there are two copies of each chromosome. Each of our somatic cells has a total of 46 chromosomes, which corresponds to a diploid number of 2N equals 46. On the other hand, our gametes, or sex cells, are haploid, which is designated as N. This means that there is only one copy of each chromosome. So each of our sex cells has a total of 23 chromosomes, which corresponds to a haploid number of N equals 23. In sexual reproduction, two gametes, namely an egg and a sperm cell, fuse during fertilization to form a diploid zygote. Gametes are formed through the process of gametogenesis. There are two types of gametogenesis: spermatogenesis, which is the production of sperm cells, and oogenesis, which is the production of egg cells. Spermatogenesis occurs throughout an adult male's reproductive life, whereas oogenesis starts in the fetus but is arrested or paused until a female reaches sexual maturity. In this video, we will focus on spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis begins in coiled tubes in the testes that are called seminiferous tubules. Spermatogonia, singular spermatogonium, are diploid germ cells that are located on the outer edge of the seminiferous tubules and can undergo a limited number of mitotic divisions to produce more diploid spermatogonia. The spermatogonia then stop mitosis and instead begin meiosis. Spermatogonia that have entered meiosis I are referred to as primary spermatocytes. The primary spermatocytes divide during meiosis I to produce two haploid cells that are referred to as secondary spermatocytes. The secondary spermatocytes undergo meiosis II, where each cell divides to produce two haploid cells, now called spermatids. Altogether, this means that following meiosis, one diploid primary spermatocyte results in four haploid spermatids. In this way, the chromosome number is halved, from 2n equals 46 to n equals 23. Following meiosis, spermatids undergo the final stage of spermatogenesis, which is called spermiogenesis. During spermiogenesis, spermatids differentiate, where their morphology, or structural form, changes and mature into haploid cells that are referred to as spermatozoa, singular spermatozoan. The division of spermatogonia and the maturation of spermatids to form spermatozoa, or sperm, are supported by Sertoli cells, which are located inside the seminiferous tubules. The mature spermatozoa are released into the lumen, or fluid-filled cavity, of the seminiferous tubules, where they travel to the epididymis, which is a coiled tube attached to each testis. Spermatozoa are stored inside the epididymis and undergo further maturation to gain motility, or the ability to move independently. Mature human sperm cells are characterized by having a head with a haploid nucleus that contains 23 chromosomes. The chromosomes include 22 autosomes and either an X or a Y sex chromosome. The tip of the sperm cells has an acrosome, which is a vesicle that contains enzymes that help the sperm to enter, or penetrate, egg cells during fertilization. Sperm cells also have a flagellum, or tail, which facilitates it moving toward the egg to fertilize it. The meiotic divisions that allow primary spermatocytes to convert to spermatids begin to take place during puberty and continue throughout a male's lifetime. The entire process of spermatogenesis takes about 7 weeks. Following puberty, sperm are continuously being produced within each testis so that in a male's lifetime, billions of sperm can be released.